This is the final lesson in our training series. Here we'll walk you through typical daily use of the register functions. Start by signing into Talech Terminal by entering your PIN. In the register portion of the terminal, tap a product to add it to an order. You can view all the products in your menu or catalog, or you can narrow down your products by category. If you're adding a time-based service, tap it like you would a regular item, and key in the hours and/or minutes required to provide the service, and press Save for the order total to be calculated. You can use the keyboard function along the bottom to sell a custom item that's not entered into the register. Enter the price, then tap Add. To edit an order, go to the Cart section. Here, you can tap an item to edit the quantity, tax, or add a note to the item being sold. You can remove an item from the order by swiping it to the left, or with the More button located on the top right, you can cancel an entire order or associate a customer to the order. From the Customer section, you can view previous customers or enter a new one. First name, last name, and email address are required for a customer. Additional information can also be added. If you need to apply a discount or service charge, you can do so from the cart screen. When you're ready, tap the Pay button and select a payment type from the drop-down menu. If the customer is paying with a credit card, press Charge and the customer can insert, tap, or swipe the card using the built-in card reader. If you accept tips, customers can enter a tip and sign on your device. Depending on your skip signature settings, a customer may not be required to sign for an order based on the value you've set. You can text, email, print, or skip the customer receipt. After you've made your selection, you're brought back to Talech's register screen, so you're ready to help the next customer. To process a return or refund, from the dashboard, tap Orders and select the Closed Order tab. All orders are listed chronologically with the most recent listed on top. You can use the search bar to find a transaction by order number, first or last name of the customer, and more. Tap to recall a transaction and choose between the return and refund option. You can also resend a customer receipt from this screen. To refund a transaction, tap Refund at the bottom of the screen and tap Refund again to complete the transaction. To return an item or items, select Return at the bottom of the screen and put a check mark next to the item that needs to be returned. For orders with multiple quantities, you can adjust the quantity of items being returned. Once you've selected the items the customer is returning, tap Refund and tap Refund again to complete the transaction. You can text, email, print, or skip the customer receipt. Your daily sales numbers are reported in the dashboard in real time. For more detailed reporting, go to talech.com and sign in. From talech.com, you can get an in-depth look at payment types, product sales, and much more. If you'd like to learn about sending invoices or setting up service charges or more, please check out the help articles linked in this lesson. Otherwise, this will conclude our training series for Talech Terminal. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Thank you again for choosing us for your point of sale.